Hello! Today we're going to go through some example problems related to conduction, convection, and radiation. Okay, so let's start with a problem related to conduction. So suppose you stand with 1 foot on a wood flooring and 1 foot on a wool carpet, making contact over an area of 80 centimeters squared with each foot. Both the ceramic and the carpet are 2 centimeters thick, and are 10 degrees Celsius on their bottom sides. At what rate must heat transfer occur from each foot to keep the top of the ceramic and carpet at 33 degrees Celsius? Well, I'm providing you the thermal conductivity of wood and wool here, alright? So let's apply the formula for conduction, heat transferred by conduction. So imagine the left hand side here, you have your foot on the wood and on your right hand side on the wool carpet. So applying for wood, we have the thermal conductivity of wood, the area touching of the foot touching the floor, the difference in temperature, and the thickness, which give us heat transfer of 110.4 joules per second. The same for the wool carpet. We just change here the thermal conductivity, and it gives us a heat transfer of 36.8 joules per second. So what does it mean? It means that the wood floor transfers heat to your foot faster than the wool carpet. Alright, let's go through problem number 2 now about convection. So imagine that during a heavy exercise, the body pumps 2 liters of blood per minute to the surface, where it's cooled by 2 degrees Celsius. What is the rate of heat transfer from this forced convection alone, assuming blood has the same specific heat as water and its density is 1050 kilograms per meter cubic? Well, we know that the specific heat for water is 4186 joules per kilogram degree Celsius, and we're assuming this is the same as the blood. Let's apply then the formula for heat transfer. We know that the rate at which heat is transferred is calculated by the mass flow times the specific heat times the difference in temperature. Well, for this case, the mass flow is the same as the volumetric flow times the density of the blood. We can now just add the values. Remember that 2 liters of blood corresponds to 0.002 meters cubic of blood, okay? Making all the calculations here, we have that the heat transferred by convection is 17,581 joules per minute, or if we divide it by 60, so we have 293 joules per second, okay? Alright, so let's go now through problem number 3, and that's about radiation. So we want to calculate the rate of heat transfer by radiation from a car radiator at 110 degrees Celsius into a 50 degrees Celsius environment. And this radiator has an emissivity of 0.75 and a 1.2 meter squared surface area. Also, we want to know if this amount of heat transfer is significant based on the automobile engine total heat transfer, right? To answer this, let's assume a horsepower of 200 horsepower, that's approximately 1.5 kilowatts, and the efficiency of the automobile engine as 25%. Okay. I'm providing you here the Stefan Boltzmann constant that we're going to use. So let's then calculate the heat transfer first. using the Stefan Boltzmann formula. We have the constant, the emissivity of the radiator, the surface area, and the temperatures, the final and the initial temperatures. Just keep in mind, these are absolute temperatures, so you need to put everything in Kelvin, all right? And we have a rate of heat transfer by the radiator through radiation of a negative 542.61 watts. Now, to answer the second question, let's calculate the amount of heat transferred from the car engine. Okay, so we have that the work done by this engine plus the heat transfer is actually the amount of work divided by the efficiency. So, and it's 800 horsepower. That's the total power of the engine. We know that this from this 800 horsepower, 200 is actual work done by the engine, and the rest of it is the amount of heat transfer. So the car's engine loses 600 horsepower through heat, right? Heat transferred. And this 600 horsepower is approximately 447,420 watts. Now let's relate these two numbers here. We can divide the heat transferred in the radiator by radiation by the total amount of heat transferred from the car's engine. And if we do this calculation, we reach this number here. The amount of heat transferred through radiation by the radiator is only 0.12% of the total heat transferred from the engine's car. So this is a very small amount. And well, that's because the radiator actually works using the conduction process, not radiation. Okay, so we have air that's being forced through the radiator, and this air in contact with the fluid in the radiator actually we have this heat transferred using conduction, not radiation. That's why this radiation amount is too little, because the most part of the heat transferred is actually by conduction.
Want to learn more? Check out the next video. Quick reminder to subscribe to GeeklyEDU.